Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. This is Krishna Shreeja. I'm currently interning with Lexus & Company and I'm in a VIP Pro badge. Now we'll discuss about the NALSA and we'll discuss point by point details of NALSA. What is this NALSA, what are its functions, what is its motto and why is it required to us, and we'll discuss all. So after the independence, I mean when our India became republic, we don't have all the laws that are required, that are essential for us. So for the purpose of this, our constitution meant for many amendments and it tries to amend itself to suit itself for the prevailing situation in our society. So one such law among that is among such amendments, one such one is 42nd Amendment, and this 42nd Amendment is called Mini Constitution of India because many changes were done to the Constitution during this period. So in 1976, during the 42nd Amendment, a provision called Article 39A was inserted to the Constitution. So basically, it provides free. According to Article 39, the Constitution. Our government provides free legal aid to the poor and weaker sections of this society. So what is this legal aid? Well, everyone don't have access to the legal services in our country. They can't afford the legal services. So for such type of people, it provides free legal aid. Okay, so now let's see how this NALSA was established. In 1985, Parliament enacted an act called Legal Service Authority Act. This act strives to provide free legal aid throughout the country in a uniform pattern. But this act came into force in 1995 on November 9th. So under the authority of this act, a statutory organization called NALSA, National Legal Service Authority, was established. It's headquartered in Delhi. The motto of this NALSA is free legal access to all. It strives to provide free legal services throughout the country. So who are eligible under this program and how can they reach out through everyone in the country? Let's see. The people, the victims of the mass violence, and the people belongs to SC or ST community, and women and children, industrial women, and people whose annual income is less than 1.2 lakh in case of Supreme Court cases, and 1 lakh in case of High Court, and the people who are the victims of trafficking and beggar, all these type of activities which are considered in Article 23 of our Indian Constitution. So these kinds of people are these sections of people are eligible under the eligible for these free legal services. So how can they reach to everyone in the country? The answer is that to ensure these free legal services and awareness throughout the country, there is a body at the state level called State Legal Services Authority, this is headed by the Chief Justice of that particular state's High Court. And for NALSA, it is the current Chief Justice of India is considered as the pattern in chief of the body, and the second senior most judge of the Supreme Court is executive chairperson of the NALSA. So to carry out these legal aid program at a rural level, there is also a body at a district level called District Legal Services Authority. It is located in a district court complex, and it will be headed by the district court judge. So this is about the NALSA. So what are its main functions? Apart from providing free legal aid to the weaker sections of the society, it also conducts lok adalats to solve the amicable disputes in a rural level, and to create the legal awareness camps in rural level in rural areas. That's it. Okay, inspired by these services, by these organization, even many law schools are also included this activity of bringing out awareness among the people about this free legal aid. This activity was included in their curriculum. And NALSA also releases its official newsletter called Nyayadeep. So this is all about the NALSA and its functions. That's it. Thank you.